Peace and Black Power. This is your sister, Dr. Deanna Bailey, also known as Dr. Oya Maat. I am here in Accra, Ghana, family, standing next to Brother Bomani, who is the co-founder of Africa for the Africans. Brother Bomani, can you tell the audience why you founded Africa for the Africans?
Greetings, family. Bomani Tamba here at Kwame Nkrumah Memorial Park, my favorite site in the history of our people. And yes, family, we started Africa for the Africans to connect our people to beautiful sites and beautiful history, but also to link them in a movement to where you're not just coming to Ghana to tour. Mm-hmm. The tour is like a build-up. Right. You enjoy the tour, you learn about business investments, and then you can get yourself organized in the country. We have investments like Garvey Town, which is a community, and there's a lot of other things that's built in the community. So we're trying to organize our people more in a Pan-African mindset that want to come to Africa, and that's really our focus. And that these journeys literally is the route to to the ultimate mission, to where we have an incredible development connection on the African continent, to where we can be infused into the continent as Africans, and after a generation or two, we're all African people.
That's right.
You know, that's everything.
That's right. So we're standing in front of the Kwame, Dr. Kwame Nkrumah Memorial. This was a part of our day one tour. Brother Bomani, can you tell me a little bit about what we saw today? I mean, I could go into what we saw, but
yeah, absolutely, family. What our tour guide went through is the history of Kwame Nkrumah from, from his birth to his studies in the diaspora to him coming back to Ghana and becoming a leader of his country based on what he learned in the African diaspora. That's very key, family.
Absolutely.
Our energy in the African diaspora have taken a lot of our brothers and sisters to another level because our fight is real,
Absolutely.
So, Kwame Nkrumah took that energy and led his brothers and sisters, and he used the energy of W.E.B. Du Bois, Marcus Garvey, Malcolm X, a lot of the prominent names at that time when he was around studying as a student. So, family, that connection from here takes us to other parts of the other parts of the day, which is W.E.B. Du Bois Memorial, like here.
I can't wait. I cannot wait to go to the W.E.B. Du Bois Memorial. I know you mentioned it when we were on the bus that we're going, so I'm very excited about that. And for those who don't know who Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, who he was or who he is, he is one of the greatest Pan-Africans, greatest Pan-Africanists, known to man. And, I'm happy to be here in Accra. I'm learning so much, family. If you have the opportunity to travel to Africa, you want to do it, I highly recommend that you travel with Africa for the Africans. Brother Bomani, can you give them your information so that they want to contact you?
Yes, family, you can check us out on our website at africafortheafricans.org. And you can just link us online. Name is Bomani Tayemba. You find that all over Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, and so on. And definitely, family, I'm one of the people you can just shoot a text to, 404-931-9429. Send me your name, number, and email address, and then I'll reach back out to you, and we'll talk more about Ghana. And we just try to make things clear and organized. So I'm available throughout the week. Right now, I'm not going to be available because I'm on tour for the next three weeks. But one of the main and most important thing about Kwame Nkrumah is Kwame Nkrumah ideology was, Ghana independence is one thing, but it's meaningless unless we work together to free the rest of the African countries.
Absolutely.
And also the other African nations like the Caribbean nations of black people. So Kwame Nkrumah had a global ideology, and he was for the Africans in the diaspora and for Africans on the continent. And that's what we need more of our leadership to be about, especially the African continent.
Absolutely.
You cannot forget about a good percentage of your people, one-third to half of your percentage of our people. And our people in the diaspora have a lot of opportunities and access to things. So we always tell folks, family, it's just not just coming on tour. It's a build-up to where we would like to build an entire African continent where we as a people control Africa, us African people, not other people like Europeans and Asians, which we see clearly are coming in. So this foundation right here with Kwame Nkrumah really just educate all of us to understand more of our mission.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And when you just described Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, I instantly thought about Julius Malema.
Absolutely. South African.
Your South African brother
EFF. We'll be connecting with them. Yes. Hopefully, maybe in November, we go to South Africa.
Yeah, and I'm considering going on tour with him. He has a trip from November the 22nd, I believe, through December the 4th.
December 2nd, it's Johannesburg and Cape Town.
And family, I will be on that trip. Your girl, Dr. Maat, will be on that trip. So, family, if you want to come out, please come out. But when you describe Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, my mind instantly thought about Julius Malema and the EFF. Those brothers, to me, I feel like what they're doing is they've captured the spirit and the mission and the ideology of Dr. Kwame Nkrumah. How do you think about that?
Yeah, absolutely. Because the thing of it is, whenever any government, any representation of African content speaks of the diaspora and reach out to the diaspora, I'm all with you, because it's one of the biggest disrespect that's been going on, where we're a minor focus. Mm-hmm. It really troubles me, mm-hmm. honestly. So even when I'm here in Ghana, we're doing all we can to make some movements and energy, and that's why we're really building Garvey Town, because Garvey Town is going to be 300 of us strong, mm-hmm. enough to have our own lobbying people in government and things like that, mm-hmm. because the African diaspora got too many resources to make things in Africa work.
Absolutely.
And you know, we have to really come as one. So family, that's all we're doing right now. We're trying to connect us, Africans and the diaspora, Africans and the continent together, and this is a good foundation. These journeys get to the point where they get addicted to it. You want to keep coming.
But, absolutely.
We know it's big, you know, the money is a little, you know, but at the same time too, we try to do at least give you the one tour to where you feel comfortable, mm-hmm. going any parts of Africa.
So let me ask you a question, yeah. Brother Bomani, real quick, because you talked about Pan-Africanism and you said a lot of other things are distractions. How do you feel about the ABOS movement? I want you to give your honest opinion. We've been talking about it on Black News 102 and Sign of the TV. And so, for those who don't know about ADOS, ADOS is an acronym that stands for American Descendants of Slavery. A lot of people say slaves, but it's not slaves. It's African Descendants of Slavery. As a Pan-Africanist, how do you view that particular movement?
I feel that movement is the same as when Marcus Garvey was pushing for us to do the same thing of other nations and build Africa. And then other leaders was just like, well, we need to focus on this in America. We need to focus on getting rights here and doing all those things. I feel like, you know, there's people in America, they're gonna be dedicated to these movements in America, because they will never leave America and go to Africa. So in that case, you know, they need to stick to that movement and make it work to help the rest of our people in America or in the diaspora in general.
So you're not against the ADOS movement?
I'm against it sometimes. It depends on how I put it in perspective.
Okay.
But more what I'm for the best of us coming to represent what we can build in Africa, because that's even more important. We have had our chance in America, honestly, and that's what I tell the folks in that movement. Mm-hmm. From 1900 to now 2019, a good 119 years. We have had so many movements.
We've
been through Jim Crow. We've been through segregation, integration.
Black power movement, civil rights movement,
and so on.
Convict leasing.
And the thing about Black America has been the privilege of the greatest black minds in the world. They usually tend to be in America.
Some of us come from the Caribbean. Absolutely.
Chance. So now it's time to focus on what we can do to build a nation and build nations across Africa where our children will only be educated by black scholars who know what they're doing.
Absolutely.
We don't have to deal with a certain system, and we'll be able to organize things to where we take care of our own family's troubles and family situations. There's too many times that we're in court system and these people's system. So those movements is basically saying that you want more indoctrination from America. You want more of America taking control of you. And
you think that's what the movement is about? I mean, is it your opinion? You can
speak
freely.
Absolutely. Okay. It's like, you know, people are basically begging for America to take care of them and begging for America to give them more, give them this and give them that. Do we deserve the things that we're demanding? Absolutely.
Absolutely.
More
yeah.
than a million times of what the things we're asking for. But at the same time, too, I know our oppressors, they are laughing at us. Mm. And they're like, these people don't have no power. They think we're just going to give them something. So instead of putting our energy into a movement that we know clearly is not going to go anywhere, because the people in power, and even if you elect 10 next straight black presidents, those 10 next straight black presidents are going to say, I am the president for America, not for black people.
Oh, absolutely. We know that the entire, and it doesn't matter who you vote for, Democrat, or, you know, if you vote Democrat or if you vote, you know, Republican. It doesn't matter. Dr. Amos Wilson tells us in his book, Blueprint for Black Power, that there are two wings. Yeah. One of your favorite?
Yeah.
He said that there are two wings on the same plane. So the whole purpose of the government is to maintain global white supremacy. That's what it's all about. So I hear what you're saying. You're saying that we shouldn't be, because, you know, ADOS is really a movement about getting restorative justice, and reparations. That's what we want. And so we're saying, hey, in America, me, my mother, and I can speak, you know, I am ADOS. Yeah. I am an American descendant of slavery. My family, I can trace my family back to the plantations in Sumter County, South Carolina, and also in on the Maryland Eastern Shore on my father's side. And so I'm definitely an ADOS person. And so the whole movement is really about restorative justice and reparative justice. And so we feel like, you know, you owe us. You owe us money, right. You owe us for slavery, you owe us for everything that took place after slavery. Because a lot of people focus on slavery, the 250 years of slavery, but they don't think about the 200 years of domestic terrorism that followed the era
you really
of,
have to do the before and the after.
Before and the after. So we're saying we want you to pay up, but I understand your position. You're like, don't wait on it. Oh, we gotta be building our own stuff,
we're,
right?
Yeah, we're taking it, exactly, and that's right. Exactly, and sometimes I tell people come off wrong because that's
no, no,
what
no,
I am.
No, no, come off wrong. No,
but
no, no.
But I let folks know that. I'm always telling people that I'm with you, with our brothers and sisters, but in order for us to get what we need, mm-hmm. we may have to make another step. We may have to build Africa to where Africa is a superpower, and in Africa demand that our people get taken care of. Especially our people that's gonna stay in America, and they need protection, and they need justice.
And so you sound
so
like,
that's a strong Africa doing that. But if Africa is weak
right.
and Black America is weak, and the rest of Black nations around the world is weak, we're just being laughed at with these movements. So we can call them many different names.
Right.
I'm familiar with Nkrumah, and when I heard about the U.S., that's one of the first things I thought about Nkrumah. I thought about all of our brothers and sisters across the planet working for.
And Nkrumah proposed H.R. What was it called? H.R. 125 or H.R. I forgot, guys. Don't quote me. But they proposed the study of the effects of slavery on Black Americans, and I think they proposed this bill. I think it was 1987 or 1989. Don't quote me, family, it's hot and I'm tired. But I think it was like around 1989, 1987, Nkrumah did at least propose a bill for the study of the effects of slavery on African-American people. But I understand what you're saying about Africa and Africans. Dr. Amos Wilson made it clear that the destiny of Africa and the destiny of diasporan Africans are inextricably bound.
Absolutely.
You know, so like you said, if we empower one, you empower the rest.
Yeah, because a strong Africa right now, which is a weak Africa, Africa can't do anything right now to help us in America.
Right.
You know, Ghana has done a lot for us, basically saying, family, come to Ghana, but the citizenship program needs to be a little more organized. That way people know that they're going to, you know, they're working towards citizenship.
Absolutely.
So Ghana is a good foundation, family. That's why we're here, and we're going to be working our way across the continent, especially in the next 20, 30 years as we build more and more a generation. So my sister, man, I'm just so happy that you're here.
Yes, absolutely.
And big up to you and Amirat Squad, my brother Ankh.
Amirat Squad.
Brother Sarnetta.
Yes.
All of our folks out there that's like just really just organizing our people and connecting them. And I understand
and peace to brother Phil Scott. He's doing some great work with the Advise Show. So peace to you, brother Phil Scott. I'm going to send this video on over to him, too.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Share the love out, because a lot of the people that you have talked about, I've known them, I like their work and everything.
Absolutely.
And even though my focus is trying to do certain things, because I feel like the best thing we have to do is focus on what you can make happen good. I've been to Ghana 16 times. It's like, for me, it's like a snap of finger just coming over here, getting people together. And that's where I'm strong at. What I'm weak at is trying to do certain things in America. And then some people have a better strength. So us working together will make a difference. You know, like you're talking about, we're going to share these videos, share the information, and really just build a stronger bond and get more of the Pan-Africanist people to work together and be more, and try to deliver more practical application.
Wonderful. So, Brother Bomani, I just want to take this time out to thank you. Before I close out, Brother Bomani, I know you guys are familiar with the Meltrek program. Brother Bomani, when I contacted him about coming on the Ghanaian or the Ghana 2019 tour, I said, Brother Bomani, can you make it so that we can present the Meltrek program at some schools?
Yeah.
And so Brother Bomani, can you tell the people the three schools that we're going to be presenting Meltrek?
Perfect, family. We have Trinity Academy that we're going to go to. It's a school and an orphanage. So we're going to set up there and we're going to have a good time, connect with the students. They're from all ages, from 2 all the way to 16. Mm-hmm. We're going to, in the next week, we're going to be going to Elmina, and we're going to go to the Akoma International Academy of Arts and Science. And that's Imacus. That's a school that Sister Imacus from One Africa is, you know, is part of the board. Then the last school we're going to go on the last day is the Garveytown School at the Garveytown Community. So family, we're gonna be working and setting that up, and you know, I love what you're doing, and thank you for bringing that to the plate.
Absolutely, I just want to thank you for the opportunity.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I'm not gonna say no.
To present the Meltrek program to the children of Ghana.
Yeah,
because we actually talk about Ghana in the film. We talk about Ghana being, you know, the Gold Coast and all of the great leaders that came out of Ghana. So I think the children are going to be excited, you know, just to see their history in animation, you know. So Brother Bomani, I want to thank you for all of your work. Thank you for making it happen. I love you so much. Thank you for
love
everything.
Love you, my sister. Yes, family.
Peace and love, family. Peace and love. Make sure if you tour Africa, you have to tour with Africa for the Africans. Peace, love, and abundant life. Black power. Good. I wanted it 15 minutes. Bomani. It's good, Bomani. Bomani, we did that. Bomani, we did that.
All right, family. That's it, family.
Oh, yeah.